I got involved with Washington Performing Arts about 3 years ago when I started my position at DCPS as Director of the Arts. So as Director of the Arts in DC Public Schools, I oversee curriculum and instruction across all art forms. And while I did not know Washington Performing Arts at the start, I was probably 2 weeks in before the name came up many times, based on the number of ways that WPA and DCPS are kind of intertwined and the services that WPA provides for our students. When we needed something, or when we were trying to work with teachers and we wanted to ensure they had quality professional development, the answer was sort of always, well, we should talk to Washington Performing Arts and see what can happen. And as soon as that conversation started, the answer was always like, sure, what do we do? Like, how can we help? What do we need to do? What are you guys looking for? So it became very apparent quickly that that Washington Performing Arts was an organization that was dedicated to the young people of DC. And because of that, dedicated to the work of DC Public Schools, and just interested in ensuring that the work that was happening here was the same work or aligned work to what we were trying to do in the arts in DC Public Schools. And over the past 2 years, that relationship for me has only deepened. And so we have continued to find ways, as I've seen the depth of the organization and the range of the organization, the ways that I can imagine Washington Performing Arts can support DC Public Schools and DC Public Schools students then enriching Washington Performing Arts. Kronos Quartet was here, and Michelle Hoffman invited me to come see them and have a chance to speak to them. But at the same time, two small school groups were here. They were invited to come. And the reason that sticks out, I think, is because of the intimacy of what was happening. It wasn't a performance space. It wasn't going to see a show. It was a very small, I think there were 40 or 50 kids total in the room. It's in a, you know, kind of a conference room. So it's sort of, it's not the normal setting in which you get to see a performance. Kronos Quartet was here and they were in jeans and t-shirts. And the students got to see musicians as people. They got to understand that there is a performance, but there is also just a person who is trying things and practicing, and they played some very contemporary compositions, and so they got to, and they sort of saw them working things out and doing a little practice beforehand. And I think that, to me, speaks to kind of the level of the relationship and the types of opportunities that WPA is always looking for to ensure that students don't just see sort of the high gloss, which is also important, but they also see everything else that is a part of being a performer. Those kinds of lessons are so incredibly valuable. I believe firmly that particularly arts education does not happen by the school district alone. It can't. We cannot support the depth and breadth of what it constitutes good arts education. And so we need the arts community to be a part of that, and we need to be collaborators in that. And as I said earlier, from the start, Washington Performing Arts has demonstrated their desire and goal to be a collaborator with DC Public Schools, so it was natural to say that we should kind of embark on this together.